The TVA, what is the relationship of the TVA? Why is an important muscle in relationship with the other muscle of the abdomen, the internal oblique and external oblique? The TVA is a muscle, a group of muscles like for the abdominal muscle, the deeper one, in different relationship with the fiber that you have. The goal of this one is to stabilize the lumbar spine. Alors, the thoracolumbar fascia, he has a lot of different layer of fibrous of fascia from the thoracic cage to the pelvis. In reality, you have three layers. You have the layer deeper, a superficial, another one. And the posterior one is the characteristic of the fusiform lamina. In the fusiform lamina, you have a lot of link with a lot of muscle, the erector, the quadratus lumbarum, and that creates the fascia of Amman Jean. After, you need to see, you have the fiber with the superficial layer. They are very, like you see, with a lot of curve. You have some curve go for the deeper one to the higher part, and the inferior part go to the lower part. The superior go cephalically, the inferior go caudally. And the goal of that, you have many goals. The first is to move the force directly from the muscle to the spine, move the force that you need to have between the different parts of the spine, between the different vertebra, and to move the force of the from the thoracolumbar spine with to the retinaculum of the erector spinae muscle, longissimus dorsi, transversus spinalis, iliocostalis, spinospinalis, and so on. That you need to know the deeper insertion attachment of the transverse in the middle layer of the thoracolumbar fascia, go to the fused lamina, fused layer, with the repeat, with the quadratus lumbarum, latissimus dorsi, internal oblique, and so on. Result of that, you have a lot of cephalic force from the deeper part, and a lot of caudal force, more for the superficial one. That means I create a lot of time a big tension that is related to stabilize between the force they want to move up and move down to stabilize all the area of the lumbar spine to protect the lumbar spine. In reality, that I explained during the course, you have different layers of fascia according with the different horizontal cutting. You study that layer. Sometimes they cross above the rectus abdominus. Sometimes they go behind the rectus abdominus. Sometimes you have different layers behind. That depends of that. You need to know exactly how to work principally for the different, for example, diastasis. That gives to you the different layers that you have with the perpendicular crossing that you have for the different fascia. You have different fibers aponevrotic in relationship with the rectus abdominus. And you know, for a lot of people, you have the many different layers with different possibilities of decussation to organize the force, the tension of the linea alba. After, it's important to know the link that you have between all these fascia and the internal oblique, because the internal oblique, at the end, finish with the TVA before the attachment of the pubic symphysis. For that, you have a lot of specific exercises to work in this way of thinking. The global view of the TVA. You have the TVA like a muscle behind the internal oblique, external oblique, and the deeper one, this one, or like a muscle more superficial in relationship with the peritoneum. Quickly, the TVA, you have two actions. One action orthopedic, like a muscle to maintain the spine, the pelvis, the thoracic cage, and to move with all the muscles. And the second TVA, TVA in relationship with the peritoneum, relationship with all the digest system, the liver, the gallbladder, the pancreas, the spleen, stomach, colon, small intestine, and so on. That is the TVA with all the classic attachments. More than 200 techniques for the TVA during the class. The classic methodology, the base is all the time in 5 GV round, breathe in and move out, breathe out and move in, breathe in and move in, breathe out and move in, breathe in and move in, breathe out and move in, breathe in and move in, breathe out and move in, breathe in and move in, Without and without. Okay. That's the classic thing. After you can add a lot of posture. For example, I show to you one. When you want to work more for the transverso-caudal part or reinforcement for the TVA directly. Now, you put the foot like that. She put both arms in this way. She lifts the head, chin in, erection, total erection of the spine, and same methodology. Breathe in and move out. Breathe out and move in. Breathe in and move in. Breathe out and move in. Breathe in and move in. Breathe out and move in. Breathe in and move in. Breathe out and move in. Breathe in and move in. Breathe out and relax. She relaxes the head very gentle. That is one set. Generally, you will do three sets in a row. When you speak about the sacroiliac joint, sometimes you confuse the sacroiliac joint and the iliosacral joint. When you have the iliosacral joint, it's because the cause of the pain of the joint, the same joint, iliosacral, sacroiliac, is the same. But the cause, when the cause is from the ilium, the movement out flare, in flare, we don't know, up sleep, down sleep, that creates an iliosacral disorder. And if you have a problem for the sacrum, at this time it's a sacroiliac disorder. Yes, for the same joint, you have the pain, the patient has the pain, the same problem. The orthopedic disorder has the same place, but the cause is not the same. I repeat, sacroiliac, the cause is from the sacrum, iliosacral, the cause is from the ilium. When you have a problem for the iliosacral, after the treatment for the ilium, you can do the TVA. For this movement, the patient is on the lateral, laterocubitus, he cross, put the knee together, and she wants to lift, until I have that. She lives with the ilium, maintain that, and now, classic movement for the TVA, breathe in, move out, breathe out, move in, breathe in, move in, 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 and breathe out and relax. Relax gentle after, same thing. She needs to do that three times in a row and on both sides. After I said to you a problem sometimes sacroiliac, you have one specific exercise. For the sacroiliac, you have during the class, I don't know, 20 different exercises. Is the problem is on the apex of the lesser arm, base of the lesser arm, apex of the greater arm, base of the greater arm. Palm up to don't force with the latissimus dorsi. The other foot in a pseudo inversion. She pushes to elongate that without any lordosis. She has a knee bent at 90 degrees, the foot 90 degrees too, and she wants to push down with the foot. And the problem now, to maintain the pelvis, she needs to contract the abs. And at the same time, to move the TVA, she needs to contract in eccentric, concentric. It's difficult to do. Breathe in, move out. Breathe out, move in. Very good. Breathe in, move in. Breathe out, move in. Number three, breathe in, move in. Breathe out, move in. Number four, breathe in, move in. Push with the heel. Breathe out, move in. Breathe in, move in. And breathe out and relax. Do you know some people that have back pain? Perhaps a lot, yes. For that, a lot need to do that. Yes, after, without the back pain, with the back pain, you have a lot of movement with the nutcracker, the name, after the delivery. It's a reverse nutcracker. That means the sacrum push a lot back out the ilium during the delivery, and it's possible after the delivery, it stays. The name is the reverse nutcracker. It's possible to move the sacrum posteriorly. The name is the reverse nutcracker. That happens only for the female after the delivery, or for the female too, because there's a big cyst like a grapefruit that take a place, you have no space, the sacrum move away. But it's not this exercise. For that, I teach during the class a lot of exercise for all the nutcrackers. The TVA is not good for the back pain, it's good for all. The TVA that I explained in theory quickly, is the goal of the TVA is to maintain the thorax in relationship with the pelvis. To maintain with the thorax all the T-spine. And in relationship with the pelvis, between the thorax, is the L-spine. In the pelvis is the sacral spine. That means the TVA is very good from the tailbone, you can say, until minimum C71. The force to the muscle to the spine, the space between the vertebra and the muscle after that with all the viscerals that you have in this area. That means all the digestive system, the urogenital system, the nephrotic system. Missing is different for each client. I want that, I have disorder, I'm too much constipated. I have a lot of specific TVA for that. I have a problem with my celiac. I have a lot of specific TVA for that. Oh no, I have a problem with my sigmoid colon. I have a lot of hemorrhoid before, a lot of TVA for that. Oh, I have a problem with my liver. Specifically, my cholesterol is too high. Oh, I have a lot of TVA for that. Oh no, no, my problem is more my spleen. My bilirubin don't work totally between the indirect and direct one. I have a specific TVA for that. Oh no, I have, and so on. It's possible via the TVA, two groups want to work the TVA orthopedically like a muscle. Different exercise for the TVA if I want to work laterally, cephalically, caudally, deeper, superficial, and the TVA to maintain the thoracic cage, to maintain the spine, the lumbar spine, the sacrum, the ilium, and so on. And the other group is the action on the visceral via the TVA. How is it possible to stimulate an ovaries? How is it possible to stimulate the mobility of the uterus? When you increase the pressure with a lot of different postures, you need to act on a lot of visceral parts. For that, the TVA is an amazing muscle.